Hey everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to solve another problem in Excel. This time we've got a big spreadsheet or a workbook that has multiple tabs, and we want to merge all this information into one big table. I don't want to copy and paste, I want to do it in a couple of easy steps in a few minutes. So let's get started. So, as you can see here, we've got some membership information of all the members that joined this particular club in December. We've got the same in November, October, so on and so forth. And it goes back a couple of years. So I think there might be about 30 or 40 different tabs we want to merge. We want to merge them all into one big table in this summary tab here. So the best way to do this is actually to open up a new workbook and drag the information in and append them all together. So let's do that. We open up a new workbook, and within the ribbon, we're going to find the data tab. And from there, we're going to go to get data from file from workbook. We're going to find that spreadsheet with all the information, select it, and press import. Within a couple of seconds, it brings up all the tabs within that table, and you can select how many you want to bring in, if not all of them. I'm going to select all of them, and you can click them one by one, or you can click the top one, scroll all the way to the bottom, hold down shift, and make sure you select all of them. Go into the next step, which is to transform the data. You click that, and this will take a couple of seconds or minutes depending on how big your file is. So I'll pause and get back to you when we're nearly done. So you can see it's nearly done processing the queries now. And once this is done, a new pop-up appears, and this is what is called the Power Query Editor. Now, if you haven't seen this before, don't stress, it's really, really simple. All we're going to do now is going to find that sheet where we want to summarize or append the information. We're going to select that, and now we're going to go over into the ribbon, make sure it's on home, and we're going to go over to append queries. Now another pop-up will appear where you can select two tables. In our case, we want to select three or more, and you can see that the summary sheet has already been selected. We're going to select every other sheet that we want to add to the bottom of this table. Going to click the top one, go down to the bottom, hold down shift, and move them all across. Now you can change the order you want them to appear. It's just automatically defaulted to alphabetical, but you can grab one and use these down arrows and up arrows to make the positional change. But I'm just going to leave them and press OK. Now this will take a couple of seconds. The dots will disappear, and now it's all been appended. Now, the last step you need to do is simply go to the ribbon again and click the close and load icon. And it's now going to process this. It'll take about 15 seconds. So in the interim, if you like what you see, please subscribe or click that like button. It'll be really, really handy. Now I'll just pause to make sure that we get all the data and come back to you in a couple of seconds. And here is the final product. You can see here we've got the summary tab now, and based on the information on the right, it's got 12,000 or so rows, which is a combination of all those different tabs. It still has all the tabs and individual information. It might have changed order depending on what you selected in that previous step. But the summary now has all the months combined, and there we go. Hopefully that solved your problem. It did for me. So see you next time.